just as soon as I see Jesus, gonna tell them all about my trouble.
Hands clapping, B. Cherie Patterson celebrates the portrayal of Harriet Tubman's life.
She was definitely afraid for her life, afraid for her family, and just through all of that had a lot of resilience to continue going back for them, because if she was free, she felt that they should be free as well.
170 years after Tubman freed herself from slavery in Dorchester and Caroline counties on Maryland's eastern shore,
with the blood and sweat rolling down my face,
a short film debuts at the Harriet Tubman Underground Railroad Visitor Center.
I read a lot of manuscripts and interviews that were conducted back in the 1800s of her, and tried to get a sense for how she talked and how she carried herself, eyewitness descriptions.
The film, shot locally and featuring some local actors, captures Tubman's entire life.
One night in the fall of 1849, she stole away from a plantation.
Born into slavery, she freed herself around the age of 27, but then returned several times to help others seek freedom.
70 family and friends, people she couldn't do without. She came all the way back here to Maryland each time to pick up her parents, her brothers, her nieces, and her nephews.
Angie Crenshaw is a park ranger at the visitor center just outside of Cambridge.
She was born about 5 miles from here in what's now known as Madison. And then she was moved to Bucktown when she was about 2 years old, and that's less than 6 miles from here. So we're in the middle of what we call Tubman Country.
When you walk into the visitor center, you see a life-size statue of Harriet Tubman, just 5 feet tall, tiny, but mighty. That bronze statue is staring at the theater. Dr. Kate Clifford Larson is a historian and consultant for the film that debuted before the movie Harriet hits the big screen this fall.
It really hammers home the story of her love of her family, her deep faith, her pursuit of freedom and equality and justice, and how the community that raised her, that protected her, taught her survival.
Remembered as the greatest Underground Railroad agent of all time, she used different landscapes, houses, barns, even boats to lead others out of slavery.
She was very comfortable in a boat. She was very comfortable in that kind of environment because she grew up here in this landscape where there's so much water.
The Eastern Shore is home for Jenny Baltimore, who portrays Tubman in her later years until her death at the age of 91.
I worked from sun up to sundown just like she did. I chucked the corn and went out and got the eggs at the chicken coops just like Harriet did. I did all of that stuff she did, all besides free the slaves.
Visitors who saw it first give it 2 thumbs up.
And what she accomplished was pretty incredible.
You can't forget your past. You might not like it, but it's there forever.
Celebrating the short film that will now play 3 times an hour at the Visitor Center.
Makes you want to know more.
For Chesapeake Bay Magazine's Bay Bulletin, I'm Cheryl Costello.